Aloha, it's Kim Jeline with Finding Your Fiji, and I'm here doing your weekly angel forecast. And this is a universal forecast, so it is for everyone. And this is for the week of October 12th through the 18th. So this week I've been guided to do something a little bit different for you guys. This is something that I do for my private readings with people. And so I was guided to do this for you guys today. So we will have our theme for the month. And then I'm going to be sharing a spirit postcard. These are by Colette Baron Reed. I love the messages in them, and they're always really helpful and I'll make sure that I hold it up long enough for you guys to take a screenshot of it as well. So, okay, so your theme for this week is the Three of Water. Water cards are all about the depth of emotion, right? So emotions. This particular card is, there's something to celebrate, right? There's something to be happy about. Maybe somebody's getting married or having a baby or got a new job or, you know, something related to connection and people gathering to celebrate, you know, even if it is, you know, online, right? Because sometimes that happens now with everything that's been going on. The other piece that's coming in with this is a message for you that you've got to have more fun, okay? So kind of stop being a stick in the mud. Make sure that you're making time for fun, for play. Every day you should be doing something that you enjoy. Every day you should be doing something that is fun for you and playful for you, right? Even if it's just having a playful conversation or a playful text or, you know, I don't know, dancing around your kitchen, right? There's lots of different things that you can do to bring that fun or that play in to your life. So that is that message for you. Okay, spirit postcard. And I'm just going to read it because it's very lengthy. So, dearest you, selfless giving is an elixir so sweet and life-giving and amazing that it should be customary for everyday living. Right now, generosity is being asked of you. Let go of a debt, release an obligation, or do a solid kindness to someone for no other reason than as an exercise of the heart. This makes me think of like paying it forward, like buying somebody else's coffee or something like that, right? You will be surprised how quickly a generous heart is repaid. We know it often doesn't happen in the immediate exchange, so temper your expectations. Know that life has an uncanny way of sending miracles, seemingly unrelated to your kindness, yet interconnected in magical ways, right? Karma. The more you act from generosity, the bigger your heart grows and the more love and abundance you will experience. We also know that someone could be entering your life with a generous offer for you. Ooh, I like that a lot. Take it and trust that you are worthy and deserving of it. You have to receive, not just give. We love you so much over here. So I'm going to hold this up so that if you want to take a screenshot of that, you can. And that way you can reread that one because it's a really, really good one. So, and feel free to share on social media. I'm cool with that. You can tag me at Finding Your Fiji. I'm on social media for a lot of stuff around that. So generosity and the idea of receiving. So a lot of people, and particularly women are very good givers, right? We're really good at giving. We're used to giving. But receiving doesn't always come as naturally to us as it does to give. And there's feelings of guilt that come in around receiving or needing, feeling like you need to reciprocate, all that kind of stuff. You don't, right? You can just open to receive, allow that to come in and know that it's a flow. Like what you're giving out will at some point come back to you, right? So all the generosity that you've done, all the generous things that you've done for other people over the years will come back to you, right? And usually in a bigger way. So have an amazing week, much love and aloha.